Bilbo decided to stop the stupid and selfish war before it could begin. He took the Arkenstone as his rightful share of the treasure and gave it to Bard and the Elven King. They offered to exchange the Arkenstone for the gold Smaug had stolen from them. But Thorin refused and cursed Bilbo. The next day, a legion of dwarves arrived, led by Dane, and three armies met on the field of battle. Anger was in the air. The men had lost their homes and loved ones. The elves knew what it was to suffer under Smaug and wanted to help the men rebuild. But Thorin would hear none of it, and so it turned to war.
Has come upon you all. The goblins of the north are coming. Behold, they ride upon wargs.
The leaders gathered for council with Gandalf and joined forces against the goblins. Bilbo decided to take his stand on Ravenhill, among the elves.
Bold army advances on the lake men from behind, and Bard knows nothing of this attack. We need someone to deliver Bard a warning.
The battle is fierce and dangerous. Who stands the best chance of making his way through?
I can do it. They can't hit me if they can't see me, and I'm faster than those ugly goblins.
You have completed your tasks, Bilbo. I would rather not risk you to this terrible battle. But if you are determined to go, I will not stop you. Use both your ring and your wits.
If we lose Bard, we lose the day. Good luck, Bilbo.
Hello, world. My name is Jebediah, and welcome to the finale of The Hobbit. Last time we recovered the Arkenstone for Thranduil, not Thorin. This time, we gotta go deliver a message to Bard. Now, there are courage points all over the place, but courage points don't actually matter. Because there are points of this level that have infinitely spawning enemies, there is no maximum courage points. If you haven't been buying Waters of Fortitude, you'll have some extra room in your health bar to keep upgrading and keep healing, but you don't need that. There are still a few chests that you can open, though. Most of the time, they contain health potions like that. But some of them are locked. We might as well use our skeleton keys. I mean, we have 9 of them, and there are only 3 more chests left in the level, so why not? I'll still be pointing out good locations of courage points in case you need them to level up.
Cowards! Come out and fight!
Those goblins have us pinned down! Use your ring and get us out of here, Bilbo!
Alright, time to save Balin, Dory, Nori, and Ori. You definitely want to use your ring because their explosive arrows deal like 15 hearts or health bubbles, so you can only survive one arrow, even at maximum health. So sneak up behind them and take them all out. Come here, you.
You're a true warrior, Bilbo. We owe you our lives.
Some rocks back there. Some courage points over there. But there are better places if you really need courage points. these wargs and most enemies, you can just run by. Wargs can kind of smell you, so your ring's not 100% effective against them. But you can run over here, find another chest. It's got some money, useless money, since we're not going to be buying anything else. But more importantly, potions of all kinds. You'll want to long jump over this broken bridge because of that. And with that chest, that's actually all the silver pennies in the level. So we're gonna heroically run past all these dwarves and wargs. We need to get that message to Bard.
Someone stop that catapult!
That seems like a job for us. I'm gonna run past as far as I can, but there are barricades in the way. What you can do is listen for the catapult. And eventually the catapult will target you and destroy the barricades. There's a lot of courage points back here. Again, we need the catapult to destroy this barricade. There we go. This is one of those places with infinitely spawning enemies, so if you need courage points, good place to use them. But let's use the catapult ourselves. Now we can head through the wall we just destroyed. Let's get these archers out of the way first, though. Ah, big bunches of mushrooms. Perfect.
Someone help me!
Corwin! I have to help him!
Corwin doesn't have much health, so I gotta get in the middle of this immediately. Alright, just one left. Do a big spin attack.
I didn't think I was going to survive, Hobbit. Thank you.
I'm looking for Bard.
You'll have to go through there, but it's full of goblins. I'll help. While you run through the gauntlet, I'll pick off the goblins with my bow. Ready?
Do I have a choice?
And there we go. We've maxed out courage points. We would get another health bubble if we had room, but we don't, so what can you do?
Have an arrow, goblin! And one for you, too. I've got you, Bilbo. Come on through.
That's shooting fish in a barrel.
We can even go invisible. Some of these goblins' wide swings might hit you, but they provide you with plenty of mushrooms. There's our target. A vine on the other side. And now we can keep looking for Bard. There he is.
What are you doing here, Bilbo?
Gandalf sent me. A large troop of goblins flanks you from behind.
So, we have a party on the way. Sounds like fun. Much thanks, Bilbo. Now, get back to Gandalf. This is no place for a hobbit.
Time to find Gandalf. nothing back here, is there? No. Got some archers on the bridge. They're kind of in the way, so... Oh, he's not in the way anymore. Gotta jump our way across here. Just checking to make sure there's nothing behind me. But down here, that's the ladder that dropped after defeating Corwin, so we don't need to go that way. Just follow the gems.
Hello there. Enjoying yourself? Your passage back to the Elven King is blocked. Just follow this path and you will meet up with the elf Lyanna. Stay with Lyanna. She will protect you. I have other business I must attend to.
Gandalf's always got business to attend to. So, where's Lyanna? Let's see if we can help these guys. There are a lot of goblins around here. Ah, got him with a rock. Oh, I still see some guys in the background. I'll take out the rest of these guys. Hopefully you two can survive. Well, we managed to save an elf. That's actually the best I've ever done. It's very hard to actually save anyone in this little fight. They're vastly outnumbered. We're gonna need some more help if we want to win this battle. So across here should be Lyanna. And now we got some other things first. Including a bunch of courage points if you need them.
What have we here?
Bilbo, get out of here. Goblin reinforcements are advancing. You'll have to go through there. Go, Bilbo, go!
There's a Waters of Vigor potion out here that will max us out on them. Lyanna can handle herself. Although, if you really want to, you can just kind of stand around her and pick up all the courage points that she makes. Makes out of goblins, I guess. This isn't the way to go. Somewhere back here, we need to find something. Mecha didn't blow up. Up this ladder. There it is. Up this ladder. We got this ladder switch lever. We'll need that. On top of this ladder. See, look at all those courage points she's making. We need to push down that blue barrel. That activates the ladder. Now we can head up.
Great work, Bilbo. Gandalf sent me to find Bjorn, but I need to hold this position. Tell Bjorn that Bolg is advancing from the north. Bjorn is the only one who can defeat Bolg. Bjorn is a skin changer and will be in the shape of a large black bear. Find Bjorn, Bilbo. Go!
This Bjorn guy sounds helpful. I could have used his help earlier. Now we've got all these goblins in the way. But they're no problem. Gravity might be a problem though. And there's a catapulting things at us. But sometimes they kill their friends. That's not very nice, but I suppose goblins aren't very nice anyway.
Oh!
Nice work. Goblins are an evil lot. No goodness in them whatsoever. If you're an enemy of the goblins, then you're a friend of mine.
I'm Bilbo. I have a message from Gandalf.
I thought he might send someone a little bigger.
Bolg advances from the north. We need you to defeat him. Perhaps I can help.
Let's see what you can do. Follow me.
Bjorn and I share the same views on goblins, apparently. We can't exactly follow him. Gotta take this little path through here.
Drop that bridge, Bilbo!
I suppose it's fairly obvious, but Bilbo is wearing his mithril shirt in this level. Doesn't actually help him take less damage or anything. Now here, we gotta head down. There's Bjorn up there. He doesn't care if you throw some rocks at him. Ah, there's a chain we can climb. And some goblins that we can get rid of. There's only three left. Shouldn't be too hard. And one guy left. Stop backflipping. There. I wanted to take those guys out first before I climb this chain because they can get in the way. But we got one final chest up here. Filled with all kinds of potions, so. Very helpful. Here's that bridge. Ah, but there's a barrel in the way. Thanks for opening that, Bjorn. So, what's next? Got no time to waste. Bjorn is trapped and pinned down by the goblin mages. we need to just run by these guys as fast as possible and follow the blue lines. You can climb up this Mario staircase or whatever. Make a big jump so we don't fall down. And got another blue barrel. Ah, I see. We're going to Rube Goldberg these guys to death. I'm just going invisible past this guy. Same for this one. Right across this chain, right in front of Bolg. And jump over these spikes in the floor that come up. Squashed by a rock. And did Bilbo just destroy a landmark? Some kind of balance rock? There's one guy left. We got one last barrel to push.
Crushed Bolg, the Goblin King. The goblins were dismayed, but not defeated. Suddenly, Bilbo saw the eagles, but then a stone struck his head, and he saw no more. The battle raged around him, a battle of five armies. The goblins were driven from the lonely mountain, but Thorin, king under the mountain, lay dying. He asked Bilbo for forgiveness. In his heart, he wished he had been more like the Hobbit, valuing food and cheer above hoarded gold. The old prophecies had come true. The dragon was gone, and gold flowed down from the mountain to rebuild Lake Town. Men, elves, and dwarves had a new chance to unite against future dangers. Bilbo bade farewell to his friends, took only two small chests of gold, and began his journey home. He had many hardships and adventures before he got back, but that's another story.
So, what do I think of this game? I like it. It's a very faithful retelling of the book, even with the additional set pieces and characters. It references the Lord of the Rings and the rest of the Tolkien mythos, and has enough exploration and puzzles to keep it interesting. I would have had the dwarves encounter Beorn before Mirkwood, like in the books, but that's really the only change to the story I would make. And if you want to experience The Hobbit, it is shorter than the trilogy. I hope you enjoyed my take on this game, and if you've watched the series all the way through, I thank you, and hope you'll rise up and join me on my next game. Stay tuned!